Hello, Herman here with a new video in the ClearPass workshop series where we built a ClearPass deployment from scratch and integrated with wired, wireless, Active Directory and much more. In our previous video, we enabled MAC authentication on the AOS-CX wired switches so we can authenticate devices that don't do .mx authentication. As you can see on the CLI, you can see we have a .1x authenticated device now on port 3 and a MAC authenticated device on port 7. However, there's just an allow access, so we don't do any specific control. So we do know the device types from the profiling. In this video, we'll change that. And what we will do is, first of all, we will add some new roles to the Aruba OS switches. We'll add access lists to the roles as well. We will do the role mapping and the enforcement on the ClearPass so we can have automatic profiling. So let's get started. So first have a look what we need to do on the switch. On the switch, we have our roles. You have seen them. We just have at this point a VLAN assignment to each of the roles. And to add more security, we can add access lists to our roles. And the way we do it is that we have the role. So here I have the role VoIP. And we can associate a policy to that. And the policy on its turn that has the different classes in it where we can allow traffic or we can drop traffic. The default action is accept. So if you see class IP DHCP, that will allow what's in the class DHCP. And then if we have a look in the class DHCP, we have a match. And that's matching all UDP traffic from any to any, and the destination port is 67. This is how we can build our policy based on the classes, and that's what we can associate then to the role. So let's have a look at a few of the examples. So we start configuring the classes, so we do it the other way around. So for the DHCP, we have that match already discussed. We can have a class for the private IP space. We can have a class for our DNS traffic. And in this case, I allow UDP and TCP port 53 to my DNS server, so the .20 and the .28. For the PBX, I can create a class that matches all the traffic to the PBX. And then we can tie that together in a policy. So for example, for the profiling, I just want to allow DHCP. Again, the default action is accept, so I don't need to put any action on it. And we further drop all the other traffic. So we just have the DHCP and we can do the profiling. For the VoIP, we can allow DHCP, we can allow DNS, we can allow traffic to the PBX, but further traffic is not needed. And similarly, we can, for example, create a policy that just allows internet. Again, we need to have DHCP to get an IP address. DNS needs to be working, but we can drop all the traffic to the private IP spaces defined in the class private. And then further, we allow everything. And similarly, we can have a policy that's almost the same, but there we allow the private IP space and we deny everything else. Then we need to tie that policy to a role, and you can see we have the profiler role, which associates the profile policy. Similarly, the VoIP role with the VoIP policy, and we have for IoT an IoT internet role, which allows access just to the internet, and we have an IoT local role, which just allows local access. So now we have this config, let's copy that and paste that in the switch configuration. So there we go. And I'm using local user roles now. You can also download the role content from the ClearPass server, then it's called downloadable user roles. And if you want to learn more about that, I would recommend you to have a look at the dynamic segmentation inside out series by Dick van Oeveren on the same channel. Now let's switch to our ClearPass policy manager. We can see our current MAC authentication policy. It has no role mapping and it has an allow all access policy, which basically just allows things. What we first need to do is we need to create some roles in the ClearPass. So let's create a role for our VoIP phone. And again, roles in ClearPass, they just are a label. Let's create one for our IP camera. And next we need to map these roles. So we can create a role mapping policy. So call it device role mapping. And now we can add rules, where we can check from the endpoint repository. We can check the device name, then we have a more specific, just Yealink IP phones, or we can check the category, and there we can have a more generic role, for example, just for all the VoIP phones. So let's take that for now. And then we assign the VoIP role that we just created. We do the same for our IP camera. So in the endpoint repository, we see we have those three levels. So we can have the category, the family, and we have the device types. It's getting more specific based on what you check for. Now we have a role mapping. Let's assign that to our service. And let's see if the role mapping works first. I'll go in the access tracker. And there I do a port bounce. And once the device is back, I can see that I have the VoIP phone role. So the role mapping based on the device category, that's working. So now we can continue. And next steps is that we need to create enforcement profiles. So similarly, like we have the profiles that we created for our .1x, where we were returning the employee role, for example, or the BYOD role. Now we will create new profiles where we will return the different device types. So the VoIP, the IoT internet, or the IoT local. So let's create those. And last but not least, we need to have a provider role that we created on the switch. So now we can create a policy based around these profiles. So let's call that AOS-CX MAC enforcement. The default, again, I take the deny access. And we can just check the tips role if it equals the VoIP role. Then we return the VoIP profile. And the same for the IP camera. And for the IP camera, we create an IoT internet role. So it can just access the internet and doesn't have any internal access. At the end, if we don't have any match, then we take the tips role user authenticated. In that case, we return the profiling. If we have a known device, either a phone or a camera, we put it in those roles. And otherwise, we will put it in the profiler role. And now we can assign this enforcement policy. And let's bounce our switch port again. Once the device is back, we can see that indeed we have the VoIP role enforced. So that's good. We can see in the radius response that we are returning the VoIP user role, and we have that configured locally on the switch. Let's have a look on the switch. If we check the port access clients, we can see that we have on port 7 through MAC authentication the VoIP role. And if we check the details for that role, we can see that we are MAC authenticated. We can see that we are in the VLAN 12, the voice VLAN. If we scroll back, we can see we have the VoIP role, and we can also see the policy assigned. So the DHCP permit, the DNS permit, the PBX traffic permit, and everything else is dropped. And we can even have a look inside those classes. So that's great for our VoIP phone. But I have another device, an IP camera, and that's a new device that ClearPass didn't see before. So let's have a look how that will work. Let me plug it in. And based on the fact that there is no profiling information, so it's not an IP camera, it's not an IP phone, it should be returned with the profiler role. We can see that actually works. So we can see there's still no device type known for this camera. If we go out and go in again, the profiling has happened. We can see that it is a network camera. And we can see there is another tab, radius dynamic authorizations. And based on the profiling, the automatic port bounce when new data comes in, we see there is a port bounce on that device. We can see that it was successfully triggered. And that means that if we wait another few seconds, we should see the new authentication coming in after the port bounce. And there it is. We can see that we now have the IoT internet role. And that allows this IP camera to communicate to the internet only, and no internal traffic except for DHCP and DNS, of course. This is how we can do some more advanced policies based on the MAC authentication and profiling. What we built was a policy that if there is an unknown device, first it will get in the profiler role, which just allows profiling just the HTTP, nothing else. Then once the device is profiled, we can see there was a change of authorization. So here in the profiler tab, we can see that we configured an AOS-CX port bounce. Once that happened, we can see the IP camera was placed in the correct VLAN. And similarly for the VoIP phone, we can see the VoIP phone was automatically placed in the voice VLAN and in the voice role. And in that role, it can just communicate with the PBX and do the basic network stuff like DNS and DHCP. So that's it for now. I hope you found this video useful. If so, please press the like button and don't forget to comment under the videos and subscribe to the channel to get notified for new videos. Thanks for watching.